In this video, we are going to learn about ribbon chart. It's a very useful and smart way of looking at the data. It's an alternative to stacked column chart. Before we get started, let's understand the data available. To keep things simple, we have just one table, 1500 rows, and every row here is an expense. On this date, someone used the silver card to buy food. That person was a male. This was the amount. The last column MN is just for making sure the sorting order for months is correct. So I have hidden that column. I have also hidden the column amount because I have created a measure, explicit measure called total amount. Now let's create some visuals. First, I'm going to start with simple stacked column chart. Let's give it half the space. On the x-axis, I'm going to add month. To make it easier to understand, I have filtered it only on 5 months. On the y-axis, let's add total amount. Let me add data labels. And now I want to break down individual month's expense by the type of expense. So in the visual, in legend, I'm going to add expense type. And that gives us a traditional stacked column chart. Each type of expense is color coded and the order remains same. On top, you get travel. At the bottom, you get entertainment. Everyone knows how to interpret this chart. And the purpose of this chart is to break down individual item by whatever is in the legend. Now I have duplicated the chart and let's change this visual to ribbon chart. If you have never seen a ribbon chart, this may look extremely confusing, but allow me to explain. To understand it better, let's look at 1 month at a time. This is Jan, this is Jan. If you look at it, the numbers are same. Blue one is 3K, blue one is 3K. The difference is here 3K came below, then 10K, then 3K, then 6K. They are not in the order of contribution. They are in the order which was determined alphabetically. So entertainment comes at the bottom, travel comes at the top. And that order remains across all months. Whereas here, for Jan, it found out who is the biggest contributor, blue one, which is entertainment. So that came on top. Who is the next one? 6K, healthcare, then travel, then fuel, and then entertainment. So it's ranked in the order of contribution. Let's move to Feb. Now the ranking continues, and you will actually visually notice that this one, which was orange, fuel, which was in fourth position in Jan, has gone to first position in Feb. And what was in first position in Jan, which is food, has dropped down to second position. It is showing me the journey of individual contributor. So not only are we seeing the contribution, we are seeing who is at the top, who is at the bottom, and how did they move in their contribution across months in this case, because whatever is in x-axis, that's the basis. You don't have to count the ranking and say, oh, this was fourth and this became first. You use the tooltips. There's a tooltip on the item itself, but there is something connecting the two. So if I hover on the connection, see what it is telling me. In Jan, fuel was ranked 4, and in Feb, fuel is ranked 1. So it's ranked increased by 3. And that increase was 212%. Amazing amount of information which are completely missing out here. I can see the actual amount. I can see the actual amount. That's about it. Similarly, when I'm looking at this one, what is it telling me? In Feb, food was ranked 2. Now it went down by 2 ranks to number 4. And that decrease was in absolute terms 2800 and in percentage terms minus 34. So that's the power of ribbon chart. From a visual point of view, the amount of effort you have to put to interpret is less, but the amount of information and insights you are gaining out of it is more. And that's the whole idea of efficiency. Less effort and more impact. So let's look at formatting options. The most important part is ribbons. So let's focus on that. Why is it called a ribbon? Because individual items are connected and it is flowing like a ribbon. So expand the ribbons and let's see. For each one of them, of course, you can customize the color. In case you want the biggest contributor at the bottom, you can reverse it. If you want the connectors not to have colors, they can be grayed out like this, but I would prefer that the colors stay, because then you can understand the story and the journey across months much better. But the transparency is something you should change. Right now, there are too many colors and they're getting mixed up, maybe confusing. So if I increase the transparency to around 60, I find it much easier to follow the storyline or follow the journey of each item across x-axis. So adjust it for maximum clarity. There is also spacing between the series. You can increase or decrease it. I prefer to keep a small gap. This makes it even clearer as to who is flowing how and where. And then, of course, you can do the standard customization for X and Y axis. So what is the conclusion? Wherever you're already using a stacked column chart, replace it with a ribbon chart and deliver more useful information with minimal extra effort. But wait, there's one more extra thing to do. Most probably, the viewers and users of your report don't know about ribbon chart. So if you suddenly change stack column chart to ribbon chart, they will get confused because nobody has told them the benefits of ribbon chart. So you have to educate them by sharing this video with them so that everyone benefits in the process. Everyone tells you to like, share, subscribe, but they don't tell you the reason behind it. No, the reason is not to increase my revenue. When you like, share, subscribe, YouTube knows that the video is useful. So it is going to show it to millions of other people who also need this benefit. So you and me together can make the world a more efficient and effective place. That's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.